Hello everyone, welcome to a legacy video. And the deck I'm playing today is Eldrazi and Taxes. And this video is sponsored to you by channelfireball.com and Ultimate Guard. Make sure to hit Channel Fireball for all the pro content. I am responsible for Modern, so you'll see all the deck guides updated, Cyber Guide, Power Rankings, all the sort of stuff up there. And Ultimate Guard is the place to go if you want to protect your cards at the best. Katana sleeves, Sidewinder deck boxes, places to put your cube, perfect sleeves, they got it all. Check it out, they have a website. If you're in Europe, you're ultimateguard.eu or ultimateguard.com if you're not from the Europe. Let's start in this very hot summer morning. The deck I'm playing comes from the trophy leader, Deltar, and he's been putting together Thalia, Guardian of Thraben, and Reality's Masher, and whenever I see that succeeding, I always want to try, even though we all know like it's not a tier 1 or anything in Legacy, but it's fun to attack with your 5-5 haste in this format as well. And alright, so this deck plays Mox Diamond, and as well as 25 lands, so half of your deck is mana sources. And what do you do with all this mana? You attempt to cast your Chalice of the Void, X equal 1. You attempt to cast your Thalia, your Arc of Emira. These are your prison effects. 3 Palace Jailer. Palace Jailer is a very good card. One of my favorite in cube. Actually, the reason, I'll be honest, the reason why I'm playing this deck is that because the other day I made a cube, you know, I have a cube with my friends, and Palace Jailer was just so powerful, it's unreal. And I just saw this list, I'm like, alright, I wanna do it in Legacy as well. New card is Enlicensed Earth. This is the vehicle that combines Relic of Progenitus with Tarmogoyf. That's the best way to put it. It's a really good card. Seeing playing, but not only is just seeing plays, it's very good in all the formats, honestly. It's like 40 ticks on Magic Online, so that must mean something. In Cyber with Swords, I think that you bring in Swords whenever you take a Chalice. Like, right? You shouldn't have Chalice and Swords in the same deck. And then you have a lot of things for the Urza Saga decks. Some Resting Papegas and some Thorn of Amethyst. Let's see if we find some opponents this morning here with Eldrazi and Taxes. Arc of the Mirror is a very good card. It's gonna be a little bit clunky to see this Cavern of Souls because you have like humans, Archon, and then you have Eldrazi. So it's not as clear as it is in other decks. Yeah, you can't. But yeah, you still got your Chalice, so. Hello, everybody. Hello, Gavin and Dr. Trunks. Good morning for this Legacy video. Yes, indeed. So, what was I was jit? It might be weird because some list of this played Stoneforge Mystic in the past. But I mean, I saw this list and I'm like, I'm so happy. Like, whenever you see Stoneforge Mystic in a deck without Brainstorm, it's always like, oh, you are going to draw your equipments for sure, and they're going to be awful. And you can't put them back with Brainstorm or Jace, and you're going to feel bad. Sure, Death and Taxes is used to play Stoneforge Mystic without those, but, you know, that's never been my cup of tea, at least in Modern. Whenever I play Stoneforge Mystic in Modern, I always feel that. All right, we find an opponent. That's great. Iponezoi. On the draw. Sure. It's not an amazing hand. Opponent most likely playing a slow deck with that Yorion. Could be a sort. Could be a variety of things from Mono White to Alluren to Four Color Zenith. But certainly something's low, so I'm snap keeping this end. Yeah, that looks like Alluren to me. Not gonna wasteland. There's a recurring joke among my team of group that you go land, mana ramp, and you wasteland, and you're just so far behind. Yep. To me, that's Alurin, which is a combo deck based around the card from Tempest that costs 4 mana. I do have Archon, so if they go Alurin, I can put into play Archon. It obviously does. Depends, but we'll see. Convoluted card for sure. Opponent doesn't shuffle and passes. It will end wave play. I think I'm going to play Wasteland. I don't want to show them the Caracas just yet. I'm playing a Licensed Hearse. It probably doesn't do anything relevant now. But maybe it does Plains, okay. Because it's Prismatic Ending as well. I mean, if it's Prismatic Ending, I'm alright. Yeah, that's, look, that's what it is. Sure. It's not Alurin. I think it's just 4-color Zenith with, I don't know, one Birds of Paradise. Maybe it has Zenith for Birds. It's 4 cards in end. I think my best bet is just to play Archon instead of Thalia Hold Up Caracas. Oh, a thing that I haven't mentioned yet. The Wasteland aren't here just to Wasteland you. It's also colorless mana for Thanatseer. Which is very relevant, because if you don't have the Wasteland, the Cavern, and things like that, the Eldrazi Temple, you just can't cast the Thanatseer. This is like a 2-colors deck if you think about it. It's not mono white. Is that another ending? Catch all answers. Point of catching it all. Oh wow, they missed the land drop. Eldrazi Displacer. Okay, so point of missed the land drop, meaning that kind of want to kill the Bayou now. So I can go Bayou Displacer. I don't want to go Thalia, because if I Wasteland and go Thalia, then I can't go Jit Ekip on turn 4. Or rather, on 4 mana. Yeah, I think I'm going to go Wasteland Displacer. Narcon. Thank you so much, Narcon. Welcome to the stream for the 2nd month. Thank you, thank you. So yeah, here I cast my Displacer as a 3-mana 3-3. Next turn, we can go Jit, Ekip, and then kill the birds. So that's going to be my plan here. If I put I didn't miss a land drop, I would have just played Thanatseer. But since they did, I feel required to just kill your land. As I don't necessarily need to cast the Thanatseer now. Wasteland. Let's see if they also wasteland me. They do. Okay, so no more Jit Ekip next turn. Island. Oh, main phase is Ice Fang Coatl. Okay. They don't have a Death Touch because they only have 2 basics. Sure. I'll play Archon of Emeria. Making my opponent's land coming to play tapped is very real. And then now if they draw a fetch land, it also comes into play tapped, so they can't get Death Touch. To the quad. Force, Pitch, Force. Okay, they have 2 cards in hand left. Three cards. I can get back Yorin. Expressive Iteration. I didn't expect that. The famous Bayou Plains Expressive Iteration deck. S clap for the opponent. Bayou Plains Expressive Iteration. That's next level. All right, so the Coatl now can get Death Touch. And our hand is starting to get clunky here. Really wish I didn't Wasteland, eh? Classic, your opponent misses a land drop, you think you might mana screw them. The reality is that they mana screw you. This is a never drain not a land. All right then, what do I do? Well, I guess I'm just casting a Thalia here. I don't want to attack. I could address a displacer these birds, but I think I'd rather cast a Thalia here. And pass, I don't want to trade. Yeah. I can put it, I know I can't next turn, but I can put a Jit here and then first strike will be better. So I don't think there's any need to act now. Leovold Uro. Plains Uro, okay. Mountain Uro, okay. Putin's looking for an Arcanist Astrolabe now. Actually, they're able to bring back Uro next turn. Because this is forest, and then they have double blue and double green. All right, next game I'll try not to mana screw them, because that didn't pay off at all. And they get back Urien. All right, they have three cards. Draw a land. Okay, that's not bad. I can go for a Thanatos here. Puna's gonna get Uro. This place are actually very good against Uro. It kills it. They draw another card though. Well, the Urien is just a good card, so I think I'm gonna take that. I know they have force for my Jit, but maybe because of Thalia they're tapped out, or they don't have a blue card or things like that. I'm just taking Urien. I think it's the most annoying card. And this is first strike, so Death Touch doesn't work. Five color basics, what are you missing? Well, fetch land are very powerful. Plus, I mean it's not like, Tier one or anything, so you don't have to get much. It's magic. You can just build the deck and go play. There isn't any requirement to fulfill some deck building rules. Okay, they have Caracas. Caracas Uro is another sweet one. Plus the Caracas can also bounce Thalia. Hello, Eric. You bought a Ledger Shredder, yeah. Can also be. Oh, attention, a Palace Jailer. Palace Jailer. Huh. We can put the opponent in jail, but at the same time, they have Ice Fang Coatto to get back the monarchy. But at the same time. If I don't Palace Jailer the Uro, how am I winning this game? Like, I Palace Jailer the Uro attack with all. I think that's good. Like, they don't have to trade because they want to take back the monarchy. They take nine, and then maybe they just die. I think it's my only chance to win. If I deal so much damage, maybe then the Reality Smasher just boom, all out of a sudden just wins the game. I think it's my only way to have a chance at winning this game. They have Force of Negation, Ponder, and now Uro in end. They get back the Uro with Caracas. That's okay. I guess they want to trade now. Okay, so they're gonna let me keep the monarchy. Sweet. And they kill the Displacer, not the Thanatos. I guess they were afraid of Displacer ability that I wasn't even considering very much since I'm mana screwed. Oh yeah, I didn't see that. You can, there's Displacer Palace Jailer. That's true, thank you chat. Okay, that makes sense why they Displacer the Jailer now. They killed the Displacer. Makes sense. I still want to attack with all though. Because if they just draw a removal spell on the either of the two, I am missing three very important damage, so it's okay. Palace Jailer has been printed in a Conspiracy set, and Conspiracy set and Commander set are only legal in Legacy. So this is why you don't see this card in Modern. Sometimes they reprint Commander cards in Modern, like Flash of Storm, Scavenging Ooze. What else? Balefus. No, Balefus Strix is not in Modern. Good morning, people. Four mana. Okay. Uro. Oh wait, they can bring. No, they can't bring it back. They have Caracas. All right, I'm 15 with three cards in it, one of which is a force of negation. And we exile the Yorin. Draw. Wasteland, I don't want that. What can I do here? I can go... just mash her. Yeah. I think I'm gonna go just Ancient Tomb, but Reality Smasher. Keep the Wasteland up for Caracas. Talk it all. Hope the noise outside isn't too hard. If it is, let me know. Yeah, oh, Charlotte's Agent. Yeah, that's the card from Commander that got into Modern. I remember in the same, I think that was Plane Shift. Plane Chase, it wasn't Commander, right? Plane Chase. I remember that, because I remember that tournament where Charlotte's Bug was first time done. I think it was GP Seattle 2012, I remember. And then, like, a lot of my friends just built that deck. Bug Charlotte's. I was playing Jund at those time with Punishing Fire. And yeah, that was a good match. Jund versus Charlotte's. Okay. They have a Coatl. Sure, I can't do anything about it. That's a good card. Better than Baleful Strix. Yeah, they draw a card here. Wow, they just took the damage from Thalia. Crazy. Okay, you draw a card. And then end of turn. I draw a card. And then I wanna Wasteland the Caracas. Is there any reason to make them wait? No. That's a good draw, by the way. Reality Smasher. And pass. I don't understand why they don't bounce Thalia, but maybe they forgot I have a legend in play. Okay, so they have five cards, one of which is a force. They have Urn the Graveyard, which will bring them to seven, so I can easily lose this game. I drew another Smasher, which is an excellent draw. Charlotte's Into Vision was good times. You know what was good times? Just casting Ancestral Vision on turn one. It was so powerful. Is Urn Death and Taxes still a thing? Yeah, why not? Sure. I mean, it's Legacy. Decks don't disappear. They stay around forever. A general misconception is that people think the Legacy events just the Magic Online one, but that's, like, not even close. That's just... Yeah, sure. I mean... There's only, like, maybe 100 people that play Legacy on Magic Online, and, I don't know, plenty more that play Legacy, so don't make the mistake of thinking the format is just the one that you see online. Okay, so my opponent's gonna be able to play Uro, go up to 7, but they kinda tapped out here, so... Mm-hmm. They have 7 cards in. Oh, Field of the Dead. Oh, yeah, chat. And they still have that Force of Negation in it, but they don't have triple blue. Very double blue. All right, so if I go Reality Smasher, how much damage can I deal? Not enough, unfortunately. What if I go Jit? Maybe opponent doesn't have a blue pitch for force. Is that possible? Let's try it. I think it's better chances than go Smasher here. Let's try it, Jit. Maybe they don't have a blue card in hand. Maybe they have 3 lands, Force of Negation. Force of Will. I should use Force of Negation. Did they shuffle the hand? I think they misclicked. But anyway, I'm gonna get forced. They have Force of Will and Force... Okay, they use Force of Negation. Sure, I should definitely. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Then I have to wasteland the field. I think I pass. It's not over yet, but I mean, I'm obviously not in a good shape. Oh, a couple of Mox Diamond just when you need them. I hope they don't have a Life from the Loam in their deck. Although playing 80 cards, they probably have Life from the Loam as well. Or maybe just Primeval Zenith for Primeval Titan for a second Field of the Dead. Five colors, by the way. I just want to point you out what's going on here. I'll put in place Bayou, Plains, Expressive Iteration, Field of the Dead. You don't see that every day. All right, let's see if they're able to Zenith the four. Yeah, they are. No, actually, it costs eight. Zenith for Titan. Maybe they have Zenith for Titania. Oh, that's another commander card that's into Modern. Titania. Zenith for four. I should have got on four. Back in the days. Oh, Omnath. All right. Yeah. Dried Arbor. Is that they're attacking with Uro? I should. Throw in the last troll. Okay. Not gonna give up though. I'm here to stay. We can draw the Displacer and do the Puzzle Jailer combo. Unless they're killing the Puzzle Jailer, which I can't do that. But I had to double block this way if I wanted to only trade Uro for a card. Actually, I'm missing a mana to go Displacer Blink because that costs 6 and I only have 5 mana. Draw. Cavern of Sauce. I'll play it and I'll pass. I could attack, but I feel like I'm just chilling now. Opponent will kill me eventually. Let's just wait until it's our time. Meanwhile, my cat is trying to enter the door, and he will succeed because cats don't fail to opening doors. In my house. Hello, gato. Okay, they go Leovo, Primeval Titan. Sure. Ooh, attenzione! There it is. That's the Displacer that I was looking for. I'm not giving up here. I am not giving up here. Oh, I can't draw a card because of Leovold. I forgot about that. I was looking at my cat trying to opening the door. Does the cat speak English or Italian? They actually don't really speak. It just meows. Is meow called speaking? I guess. Meow. Doesn't even speak that much too, compared to other cats. It's very silent. Yeah, the lightning bolts, they're good. Yeah. Okay, my opponent just dirtle around. I have the Displacer plus Palace Jailer combo. Does the cat meow in Italian accent? Maybe. Maybe they heard meowing other cats. Actually, my cat never leaves the house, so. Even when the door is open, it just stays inside. So he probably doesn't even know that there's other cats in the world. I don't know how it works. Strange concept of life for sure. Okay, Zenith for three. Ooh, is there ramming up excavator? It's grist. Oh no! Exile another creature. Oh no! So they sacrifice the grist. They're gonna target my Eldrazi's wizard. Hey, I need to blink something. Sorry, I need to blink the palace jailer. And exile the Titan. Yeah. Opponent's gonna draw a card. I'm gonna lose the monarchy. I should probably not do in the palace jailer, right? I really have no idea what I'm doing. I am just clicking buttons at this point. I am simply clicking buttons at this point. Waiting for my opponent to kill me, which will inevitably happen soon. Green, white. Okay. I think I want to take out the Mox Diamond now that I saw Collector. Oof. No, maybe not. Maybe a couple. Mox Diamond isn't the card you need for. Why didn't you attack? What's going on? All right, if the opponent doesn't want to kill me, I'm not gonna concede. Like, I could draw another Eldrazi Displacer, and if my opponent doesn't kill me, I'll just like exile two things per turn. Isn't there a way to permanently play with Palace Jailer? Permanently exile with Palace Jailer? No, there isn't. That's with like, I don't know, Mesmeric Fiend, or I guess, yeah, and then you sacrifice it, but that's not current way. Yeah, Fiend Hunter, Tidalus Collar, you know, those old ways of two triggers, but Palace Jailer is different. You just get the card back whenever you get the monarchy. What? Wait, when you don't attack opponent? Alright, Displacer. Thalia. I don't want to show them that I play Chalice. This game is mostly going to be over. Okay, second palace jailer. There's a point where they want to deck themselves. Plow. I gain two life. Good old plow on the palace jailer. Plow. All right, opponent gets it. Okay, congrats. What's the opponent playing? Their deck is called Four Color or Zenith, I would call it. Okay, they successfully defeated me. What are the bad cards? Sorry, the good cards. I want to keep Chalice. They do have some one drops for sure. Maybe I just bring in a couple of resting Papegas. Do I want to bring a third one? Nah, I think two is enough. I think two resting pieces is enough. Opponent uses graveyard, but doesn't use graveyard that much to justify drawing two rest in peace. The games are long, and I don't think I've seen any way to destroy an enchantment. Yeah, they're adding Chalice of the Void to Historic. I saw it. Sure, whatever. I stopped reading the arena news. So swords. Okay, swords and chalice. I don't think they can go in the same deck. So whenever we're bringing in swords, we're taking out chalice. That's probably gonna happen against like the Dark Depths decks. Alright, keep. We have turn one Archon of Emira. That's very powerful. So I go Ancient Tomb, Mox Diamond, discard Plains, Archon of Emira. Now I can Wasteland their next land and play Thalia. Like, this is going to be, like, too good. Especially because, unless they have basics, which, I mean, they play plenty of, they have to play a tap land. Even if it's a fetch land, it's tapped. So here, we can go... I'm still going to Wasteland the fetch land and play Thalia. And this is my... The death and taxes part of this deck. Now, sure, I can cast the Smasher, but I mean, they are on zero lands. Versus our clock here. One land now. Remember this deck playing Lotus Petal? Sure, if you don't have the Mox Diamond, you can easily play Lotus Petal. It might even be better, to be honest. Oh, Mountain. Oh, nice draw, Mangu. I'll play Smashy here. They're gonna probably just go Plow on something. Oh, Brainstorm. Pam, 5. Pretty good, pretty good. The two Mox Diamond delivered here. Nice. Nice draw. Well, we won the games. We won the game, so it means that the deck is perfect. Don't need to change any card. Chalice of the Void. Maybe the reason why, again, like, I don't mind about it at all, but maybe the reason why they added Chalice of the Void in Historic on Magic Arena is because they want to nerf Blue-Red Phoenix. I don't know. They want to make people buy Mythic Rares. Maybe. That's probably it. Oh, did I not submit it? Alright, sorry. Sorry, opponent. I thought I clicked, but it didn't. Well, we got lands and spells. This is much worse than the previous ones. Much worse than the previous one. In fact, it's probably not even remotely competitive in Legacy, but we're here, so I click keep. Wait, let me actually go turn 2 Thalia, turn 3 Thaumaturge here. I've seen the worst. Bayou? Oh, is the birds? Birds too strong. Birds too strong. Plenty engineer. You don't have a land. Noted. I'll write it down. I'll write it down. So last game, I wasteland my opponent and then I lost. The wasteland automatically made my opponent show up 7 lands on top of my opponent deck. So I'm not gonna wasteland. That's a hand of Magic the Gathering cards. This is one of those hands that you look and you'd be like, I guess I just take Plow. I let my opponent iterate here. Brain stonks. Did they find a land? They did. It's cost 4 though, so they can't end it. They can Uro and set up the Uro for the next turn. This is why I'm not the biggest fan of casting Thanos here against an opponent with 5 cards. Like, sure, we took Sword, that's good. But they often just have a lot of good cards, you know? Maybe Sword Supply Share is better than Wasteland in this than Chalice in this matchup. Could be. Draw. Oh. A nice Thalia, thank you so much. I think I have to offer the trade and just play Thalia here. Pretty bad, I know. I think my hand was just too fair to compete, but I don't think you can mulligan that hand. Maybe I shouldn't have brought out the Mox Diamond, but even if I had the Mox Diamond, I have 2 lands in hand. Yeah, I think the mistake here was to take out Chalice for a Plow. I think I should have done that. All right, so they played a land. Gonna bounce Uro. Draw. Dual land. Arc of Emeria. Could be worse. Play it. Go. All right. Oh, they play Force. Okay. Pitch Uro. Wow, okay. I guess they have another one. Their hand is ending iteration, so it's not a bad end. But they pitched Uro, so that's a good news. Omnath. Ability on the stack of bounces so that they can't do anything too crazy with the fetch land. They can ending my Thalia, funnily enough. Because the way Thalia and the Sunburst, it's worded, or rather Converge, it's worded, is that you can just... Okay, they're not gonna ending the Thalia. Okay, Collector Oof, sure. Draw, ooh, Cavern of Sauce. Not bad. Eldrazi. If I wanna go smashy, yeah, I have a second Thalia. I guess they can ending this meshy this way, but whatever, I'll leave with that. They go to 13. The Uro is exiled. I put an exiled. It's here. So, we'll see how it goes. Blue, red, white. Maybe they don't know the rule about. Okay, no, they just play iteration. Sure. Sure. And exiled Grist. Grist costs only 3 mana. It doesn't have the Thalia tax because it's a creature. Grist the Angertide. It's a creature in hand and on the stack. I mean, I guess on the stack doesn't really matter. There it is. That's the Grist. Let's see what they do with it. They might just kill my Smasher this way. They didn't slam Omnath again. I think they don't have a fetch land. Or rather, a land. Okay, so... Wait, you don't have to discard a card? It's only spells? Oh, wow. Okay, sure. Drop. Ooh, another Smashy Smashy. Let's cast it. Hey, where do I go with it? I think this one goes face and this one goes on Grist. If my opponent wants to chump block, I can. Okay, so they chump blocked and then made a token, milling a card. My opponent has ending, has six cards in hand, among which ending. And then you play Omnath. Let's see if they have a fetch land this time. They have just a land. Okay. So they go up to 12. Maybe now I'm regretting not having killed Grist. The classic, right? You don't kill a Planeswalker and then you regret not having done it. And then you play Abundant Growth. Sure. And then you pass because you've done it all. Yep. Drop. Rest in Pepegas. Not bad. Maybe a little bit bad. Not bad. Let me go Caracas the Omnath. Caracas the Omnath and cast Rest in Pepegas. This Smasher kills Grist this time. That's okay. I think killing the Oof was relevant. I have Jit. I have things. Yeah, let's just play this and pass. I don't want to wasteland any land. My opponent has Caracas and Field of the Dead that are annoying lands. Opponent is the biggest enemy is the clock. Yes, indeed. Clock is a very important resource on Magic Online that you need to manage. Opponent pays 3 for Italia. I have tapped my Caracas because I had to bounce the Omnath. But I have a second one. Did you attend the game day to win it? Are confident? It's going to be this Friday in my LGS. Double Master Draft. I'm going to go there to attempt to win the Dare Confident with the store name written on it. Well, let's go. Let's smash this world. Is opponent dead on board? Is opponent dead on board? No, it's not. I go to 1. I almost did. Smashy, smashy. The third reality smasher. Opponent is at 1 life. 1 tiny little life. They have Omnath, though. Fetchland. Okay, no Fetchland. Very good news. Just a forest. And then they keep up mana. Yeah. Keep up mana. Opponent's dead at the moment. So they need something. Ooh, Palazzo. But if I Palazzo, I can't Caracas. Should I Caracas or Palazzo? I think I'm just attacking here. Ooh, they conceded. Nice. GG. So they don't have swords. I just attack, they block, and I Caracas the Omnath, and boom, trample. Dead attack, question mark. This attack? Yeah, this attack, eh? This attack. This attack was not good. The timer pressured my opponent into playing not very well, for sure. It's hard to play those decks. It's not an easy task, I'll tell you. It's not an easy task. Round number 2, I'm on the play. Would you like to play first? Yes, thank you very much. Okay, this hand. Salty Shakespeare. This hand, we have a turn 3 play with a Ganjo. Turn 4 play with Palace Jailer. This is probably too slow. I'm gonna mulligan. Okay, I keep this one. The question is, what do I bottom though? It's probably gonna be an Eldrazi Displacer. So that I have a turn 2 Displacer, turn 3 Smasher. And I keep the planes so that I can make my Displacer uncounterable and then also have planes to cast my spells. Quirrell Ranger, so that's elves. Since this is elves, I don't need to make my Eldrazi Displacer uncounterable. And I'll use the cover for double white for Palace Jailer. You remember when Eldrazi was a menace in Modern? Even after the Iovugin ban, the banned Eldrazi was a deck. I guess they just not gonna print any more help for the Eldrazis for a long time. So, you know, since that 2016, I think it was. Yeah, I think it was 2016. Anyway, opponent goes Elvish Visionary. This doesn't seem like a good matchup. I'll try my best, but Jit Umezawa's Jit is going to be the most important card. Jit. Okay, this was my curve. Unfortunately, the three draws were pretty awful, but this was my curve, so. Opponent can already go just natural order here easily with Gaia's Cradle, or even just go off with Glimpse. I mean, they're playing a Legacy deck, and I'm playing a... I don't even know what this is, but yeah. The Chalice of the Void used to shut off this deck entirely, but now with Alizar Shepherd, it doesn't anymore. Even simply a Progenitus. Don't even need to kill your opponent with Behemoth. No creatures by cost. Come on. Okay, I got four of this at least. Yeah, not even any cyber card for this matchup, huh? We do have Umezawa's Jit. That's the most important card. Will I take out Chalice? I think so. At the end of the day, they have four Alizar Shepherd and four Greenson Zenith for Shepherd to play around my Chalice. So I'm just gonna bring in Plow and that's it. Yeah, I'm not playing Stoneforge. I'm not the biggest fan of Stoneforge. I mean, obviously here it's good because you tutor up your Jit. The problem with Stoneforge in this deck is also that you don't have that many lands to cast it. Like, you don't wanna... Casting Stoneforge with a white mana, it's bad because then you can't vial the whatever equipment you tutor up. So you have to actually to get the planes. It's not easy. It's not easy to cast Stoneforge in this deck. Early Archon. Yeah, that's true. Archon of the... The thing with the Archon is that... I mean, again, I was playing Elves a lot these days. You can check my videos on Shadow Fireball on it. You just natural order for Progenitus against these decks. I'll go close the window because the wind... Okay, they go for Heritage Druid, so that's the fourth mana that they need to play order. Solitude with Displacer. Yeah, Solitude with Displacer is a good combo. But I don't think you have nearly enough white card. You have like 11, because this is the Void. So yeah, Solitude. I mean, it's another deck where you play Solitude and you play, I don't know, Flicker Wisp and things like that. Is Tom Bledek got second this weekend in the challenge? If you like Jessica Stoneblade. Again, I think Stoneforge is a good card in the right matchups. But you have to pay every brainstorm to me. These type of games is where you wish there was the rope. The problem is that I'm gonna lose terribly and also just do nothing for 10 minutes or something like that. Yeah, no, I actually love the rope on Magic Arena. I'm a big fan of playing fast and lose, and the rope rewards you for that. It's a very common play pattern in my videos, if you watch them, is I make a play and then I'm like, oh, I made a mistake. Just in the literal second I made the play. Whereas, you know, my opponent's not gonna do that play and think they made a mistake because they thought, like, I don't know, for 5 minutes. Which is fine, you can do that, so... There is no time. In paper magic, also, basically, there is no time. Because, well, the judge can tell you to play faster, but if you're making plays while you play faster... Next week, chat, I'm going on a vacation. My first non-magic vacation in, I can't remember how long. Probably near. Disney cruise, treasure cruise. Now I'm going to Croatia, which is right in front where I live. So I live on the east side of Italy, on the seaside, and we're taking the boat and we're going to Croatia. I think it's time I write something to my opponent. I know it's rude or anything, but this is just like, I don't know. I'll write a single dot. You write a single dot just to make sure that connection, the Magic Online connection, didn't fall you. Because Magic Online isn't like Arena where it actually closes. You just stay there, the time passes, you're disconnected, but you'll never know. Oh, finally, a natural order. I really thought they didn't have it. Is that a David Johnson shirt? It is, yes. Archon of Valor's Reach. They choose instant. Okay. So nobody can play instant. And then they besiege my Eldrazi temple. Okay. See? After the dot, everything came together. Smashy, smashy. So that's a 5-6. That I can tap. What do I name? Well, that's... Name human. And then I tap the Archon of Valor's Reach. And then I attack with all. You forgot to mention it. You're looking at your map of your Decameron, Antitrazioni Gallia. Yeah. If you go to the Vatican museums, the one that are in Rome, I'm sure that most tourists have been there. There's a room with all the maps, and there's also Senigallia in there, because the city where I live has been founded by Romans. So, actually not actually founded by Romans, founded by Gauls, and then conquered by Romans. Anyway, do I cast the Alicensters? That's 2 damage, and I can't even activate it with you if I don't think I'm casting it. So here, I mean, obviously I die to a hoof, but I assume they don't have it, because they really... That would be bad if it is. Nah. You know what's also, well, you know what else is bad? This card. I'm really surprised to see it. Of all the legacy deck I could pick, I chose this. Yes, that is the content creator life. Out of every option, I have to make a choice. And I chose this deck. Mostly I chose it because of the love towards Palace Jailer. Ma come Natural Order? Ma mai slow rollato come... Che... Opponent, I wish you the worst. I wish you draw zero lands in both game 2 and 3. It will never happen. I wish you draw zero lands against the other opponents. Do I take out Chalice of the Void? I think so. I mean, Alison's Earth is bad as well. Should I just have a random creature? Like a Cathar Commando? Yeah, is that Chalice worse than... I mean, it's... They're both awful, I think. Maybe Chalice can cheese them if they don't have to... But they also have swords now. These cards just don't... I guess I can just bring in the Cathar Commando and attack. But it's really bad, because it's a 3-1. Trades with any... Even trades with fetch lands. Alright, I guess I'll have 2 Chalice of the Void. Oh, it's really too terrible. Chalice of the Void is really too terrible. Like, it's already a bad card against elves, now that they have 8 answer to it. Plus, it counters your own plows. Chalice on turn 1 is low them down. I mean, if they don't have Shepherd or Zenith, yes. But if they do, it doesn't do anything. Thorn is non-creature. Yeah, yeah. No, if this was a sphere, then I would have definitely brought it in. But as you can see, sphere hurts me very much. I think it's kind of a matchup that the player who I net deck from, Deltar, which is the trophy leader in Legacy, just decided to give up on. I mean, if you think through about this hand, it's not that bad. Like, I can't cast Plow, but I can't cast turn 2 Talia, turn 3 Thanatosir, most likely. I think I can't mulligan this hand. Containment Priest. Yeah, there isn't Containment Priest. That would be a combo with Eldrazi Displacer, I agree. Also combo with Palace Jailer, Containment Priest. Draw. Plains, okay. I'll go Thalia here. Taxes my sword, but I don't think it's a big deal. I don't want to sword anything now. Would you say the MTGO League is too small sample size to understand the meta? Of course. You can't understand the meta anymore. The meta doesn't exist. It used to be a thing in competitive Magic some years ago. But in these type of formats, it's just... especially like the more you go back, the more people will just play whatever they like. Or whatever they own. That's not a thing. Card availability is a huge deal in these formats. You can say that you know what's going on, but no one. Okay, I'll play Thanatosir because we need to discard the. If they triple block, that's pretty good. Let's just attack now and then I'll play Thanatosir post combat. Commoner's Soul is gonna name. Humans because they have Palace Jailer. humans. And then boom, TKS. This card is in my cube, despite it's so hard to cast. But whenever you cast it, it's such a pleasure, such a joy. Yeah, yeah, they have the Shepherd. Glad I have Plow instead of Chalice. I mean, this is rather easy. Let's take the glimpse and wish you the best of luck. Actually, no opponent. After that deadly slow roll in game one, I wish you. I mean, I know, it's not slow roll, blah, 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 blah. They were just optimizing the play. I know, but still. Playing the white deck makes you complain about the opponent thinking. Archon seemed pretty good. You think I should have played Archon? So my fear was Natural Order. It wasn't Glimpse. My fear was Natural Order. Because they go Order for Progenitus. I can't beat it. So I think that going Natural Tonnotsir was more important. I guess you're like, they couldn't have gone Natural Order if I had Archon in play. That's a good point. Because they didn't have an elf. They didn't have 4 mana. Yeah, maybe I should have gone Archon. Point has 3 cards in hand, and they also have the Alizar Shepherd, which will turn all their creature into 5/5 soon. No, but I think Archon would have been good regardless, because they couldn't cast the Natural Order, so I should have played Archon here. That was a mistake. But I had the rope, I couldn't think. I just need to click the button immediately. Those are the rules. They aren't. You should actually think through every play of yours. I was just excited to play my TKS. Was Swording not? No. Swording the Artigerid? No. I don't think so. They even have Wire of Symbiote, so you had to sword the Symbiote. Alright, draw. Oh, mwah. Cathar Commando numero dos. Exactly what I wanted. Thank you, deck. Whatever, I'm just dead on board to the Shepherd. Okay, this has been a long game where we had no business in winning. Maybe if I played Archon, I would have some business. Maybe it's too many burn spells because I have 4 Bolt, 4 Fire Eyes, but this makes you reasonable against the blue decks, the fairies. Could also be more Wild Growth. Yeah, could be that. Is it Pauper or Legacy today? No, this deck is illegal in Pauper because it doesn't have the initiative card. Boarding party is the 6/3 Cascade Ace. My fear of playing with Wild Growth is that you flood too much. But at the same time, yeah. Alright, we find an opponent. Round number 3! Vamonos! On the play, yes. Whoa! I like this end. I like this end very much. Am I playing this just for content? What am I supposed to play things for? what do you think I do here? Okay, let's go round number 4. Round number 3. The opponent kept 5 cards only. I don't think they're going to wasteland me on turn 1. Maybe they do. Utopia's Brawl. And they choose white, so that should be Enchantress, probably. I'm gonna choose humans here, then. If that's Enchantress. Then I play the Mox Diamond. And then I play Thought Nuts here. 2, 3, 4. Donuts here. They got four cards. Let's see what they have. Our good thing in China is going to see this. Huh. Alola. Cetus gains life. So I guess it's the... But Cetus can be Palace Jailered. I think I'll take the Enchantress. It's probably not going to matter. But... Because they play the Enchantress and then I just take whatever. Yep. On thin ice you drew? That's a good draw. Okay, draw. Okay, I'll play another Thanos here. See what's your hand. Another on thin ice. And pass. Another on thin ice and pass. Okay, they play Cetus. I did. Okay, they got two cards, one of which is an Enchantress Presence. Drop. Palace Jailer. Okay. This is Shroud, and this gets bounced by Caracas, so... still probably playing the Palace Jailer here, as it's the card that will make me gain... Oh, wow. The block and bounce. I didn't even consider this. Huh, guess I should have played Palace Jailer first then. Maybe if I had another Eganjo, I would have killed it. But I don't. Let's play Palace Jailer, do nothing because this is Shroud and pass. There is one single tournament that you remember more fondly than others. I mean, the tournaments where I do well, I certainly remember them fondly. Oh, my best time. Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe the Mythic Invitational. Sarah Sanctum. They got four mana. Sorry, three mana. This isn't enchantment. Oblivion Ring. Oblivion Ring. You draw a card. Yeah. Okay, now we got Cathar Commando. This is good. Thorn of Amethyst, probably good. Taking out Good Old Chalices. Anything worse than that? Oh, a License Hearse and also Jit. Katakin's bad. Chalice on one stops actually a lot of things. I'm gonna keep Chalice. Maybe Displacer is bad. Maybe Displacer is bad. You think Jit keeps my point? It kills my opponent fast. It could be. Alright, I'll keep this handed. Very slow, but those things. Alright, put him out against 2-5 again, but that didn't hurt them game one. Eldrazi Temple, Yargo. Forest go. Do I play Chalice? No. This one names humans for sure. I think I want to go Thalia Thanos here. Yeah, maybe Jitta kills them fast. But you know, the classic, I have to be here and actually click the buttons of the cards that go out. I think I want to go Wasteland for sure. Actually, if a Wasteland, I can cast anything else. Clunky. All right, let's play Thanatsir then. Let's play TKS. Look at your hand. Again, they mulligan to five. Can't be. I think I'd rather play Thanatsir than Chalice and one this turn. Remember, if I play Chalice, I have to tap all my lands. Wasteland plus Talia. Ooh, they go solid. Shit, pitching on thin ice. Okay. Well, you are supposed to think that they played a wasteable land, maybe. I'll take the Cities since they can't cast Enchantress Presence because that costs four. Forest Enchantress Presence is their hand. Italia obviously played out pretty bad because they also had Caracas to bounce it. Draw. I'll begin by attacking. And they bounce it. Okay, so now I can play my things for cheaper. Bah. I'm certainly wastelanding. And then what do I play? I can play Mox Diamond as well. Certainly wastelanding. I can play Mox Diamond here if I want to get double white for Palace Jailer. What if I just. Maybe I don't want to play Mox Diamond. Maybe the wasteland is more important because my opponent draws a Serra Sanctum or something like that. Yeah, I'm honestly just playing Thalia again. Playing land and pass in the turn. Okay, Wisdom of Teeth. So they drew the white source. I still can cast Enchantress Presence though. I think I'm gonna play the Thorn of Amethyst here. Over Palace Jailer. Force of Vigor, maybe? No. Okay. Chandra Presence costs 5 now. They don't have a land. Can't go Chalice on Tutor Stallia, and now also Thorn. Let's go Palace Jailer just as a Jace Mind Sculptor card. What's that? Oh wow, you cycle cast out. Sure. No abilities because this is a Shroud and pass the turn. Okay, so yeah. Shape for sure here. Jurassic Temple. Question is, do I want to go Chalice onto? I certainly have a lot of two drop, but I have Cavern to make my humans uncounterable. And they have a lot of two drops that they can cast. I think I'm gonna go Chalice onto here. So I can cast my humans two drop via Cavern. Opponent seems to be locked down. Okay, I can't cast this one. It doesn't matter that I pay four for it. I still can't cast it. Those are the rules of the game of Magic the Gathering. The converted. Okay. Solitude. Pitching Hallowed Haunting. What? Okay. Solitude, would you exile Thalia? Alright. Opponent's gonna be able to play Enchantress Presence. Actually, why didn't they cast it in their turn? I don't know. Yeah. Do I cast Palace Jailer? Sure. 4 mana 2/2, here we go. Oh, I forgot about Cathar Commando. I should have gone Cavernous Soul's name human. Now I can't cast it. Alright. Draw. Wasteland. Well, let's attack you for 4. Then I'll play this. Name again, human. And pass. No more Thorn. There's a Chalice of the Void. X equal to. I drew the Cathar Commando at the end of my turn because of the Monarchy. Worship? Oh, wow. Okay. Thank God I have a Cathar Commando then. On the nice. Now, question is. If I go Cathar Commando now and attack with both, they just go to 1. So maybe I should just take my turn here. If I go Cathar Commando and attack with both, they just don't block. And then they go to 1. I think I'm just taking my turn. Okay. I'll play Thalia, uncounterable. I'll attack for 2. I guess I can also play Mox Diamond, why not? And pass. Now, whenever my opponent will attack, they don't block, then I flesh this in and kill the worship and win. They play this card. And they pass. Perfect. So I think my plan now goes to fruition here. I'll just take my turn. On top, I'll keep draw. Just attack. Block. They don't block. And then I play Cathar Commando. Uncounterable. Kill Worship. Win the game. All right. Yeah, let's go. Thank you, Marlage. One for this round number 3 against Enchantress. A deck that also function in Modern. I've played a league with it in Modern. Of course, Legacy has a lot of more powerful cards like the Argothian Enchantress, the Serra Sanctum. But as you saw, the obviously the power level of... Okay. I keep this hand. We got a turn one Chalice of the Void on one, which is, in theory, what you should do with Chalice of the Void. Okay, Mulligan to six, and don't have a Utopia Sprawl. Interesting. Gonna go Eldrazi Temple, Mox Diamond, discard Plains, and then play Chalice on one. Because my opponent can have, like, On Thin Ice and things like that. Collector, oh, Encoding Enchantress, sure. Nice. Let's go for a, you know, Eldrazi Temple, and Conda of Amaria. Amaria. Now this will let the Fetchland come into play tapped, as well as every player can only play one spell per turn. My land come to play untapped, but I still can only play one spell per turn. If opponent mulligans to 5, do you put them on a fair or an unfair deck? Unfair. They played on Thin Ice just to cycle it through the Chalice, and they play Serra Sanctum tapped. Unfortunately, I'm not really drawing Kree Eldrazi to jam, so I can only play land and pass in the turn. I wonder if Lore roll Caracas, even though they do have Cithis, so maybe I should have played it. Enchantress Presence. Yep. The one can die to my Cathar Commando, so maybe I should. You can't play another spell, opponent. One spell per turn. Pass, please. Pass the turn, please. Draw. Hehe. Not much is going on here. I think I want to kill the Enchantress Presence. Maybe not. Yeah, maybe not. I'll let you draw cards. Well, I need a 3-1 to attack, I think. Sanctum Weaver. This is another MH2 card. It's basically Serra Sanctum, but on a creature. But it can be killed. So that's your turn. That's your turn of a play. You can make another play. I really wish I can draw Palace Jailer here. Or a Smasher. You know, one of those cards. And bitch, a Solomox Diamond. I had 29 lands. You feel them all. And I pass. What do you have end of turn? Do you have any instants? Force of Vigor? Maybe Force of Vigor. Solitude, maybe. That's the card I have. 4 mana. 5. What's that? Solitude? Yeah. Yeah, that's it. I mean, I honestly just played 3 spells this game. Which were the spells that I kept in my opening hand, I'm pretty sure. So. Then I'll lose. On Thin Ice. I could have Cathar Commando killed Enchantress Presence, I know. Yeah, that basta, basta. Okay, okay, I concede. All right. 1 and 2. Round number 4. Against Pat Lam. We got a turn 1 Thanos here. If that's not what you signed up for, then I don't know what you signed up for. I'm on the draw, but still a good choice. Still a good start. Ooh, Ancient Tomb. Opponents on the whole Breacher Echo Beyond deck, maybe? Yeah. I mean, they can actually combo me turn 1. Oh, okay. What? Galvanic Relay for 3? Wow. Thanos here does nothing now. Come on, I have a turn 1 Thanos here and you just... Okay, okay. So you can cast these spells next turn. It's just mana, though. No, vabbè. Come on. One time that I have a turn 1 Thanos here and... And you play a Time Twister on turn 1. Come on. Alright. It's not bad hand. not a bad end. I've seen worse. All right. Opponent passes with these three cards that they can cast next turn. Draw. Let's go for a Mox Diamond. Discard Plains. Mox Diamond. Discard Aldrazi Temple. And then Thalia. And this should be annoying, at least. They even wrote a sad face? Makoma sad face. Opponent. We have a say in Italian that I can't replicate now on this channel Fireball video. If I would be streaming for my YouTube channel, I would have said it, but I have to respect my employee. Here, my employer. Sorry, not employee. I used the wrong word. Opponent now has to do all the algorithms and the calculus to come up with the best play. In the meanwhile, I'll tweet about my previous end. Okay. Well, you played cards. Yeah, you keep on playing cards. Okay, Chrome Mox is equal. Imagine if I just had an Archon of Emeria here. That would be nice. Can I draw Archon of Emeria next turn, deck? Deck, listen to me. I would like to draw an Archon of Emeria. You pitched? Overmaster. Okay. Grim Monolith and pass. I'll play Palace Jailer and pass. You've never seen Overmaster in your life? Sneak and Show used to play this card back in the days. It's like Veil of Summer. It's Veil of Summer, but Sorcery Speed. Yeah, opponent has 12 mana on turn 3, but the Thalia is definitely gonna mess up with their calculations. When you read Overmaster, it really puts you into perspective on how strong is Veil of Summer compared to it. Veil of Summer is instant, so you can just blow up your opponent with it. It counters every spell can be countered, not just the next one. And it's also uncommon and not a rare. No, Shatter's go smashing. Okay. Pass. Put a 6 cards in hand. If they don't kill me, that means they're very unlucky this game. Burgee. I have a pioneer deck with Burgee lined up soon. Combos with Greg Ningus and a bunch of things. Overmaster is not just strictly worse than Veil. You can cycle it any time. Any time. It's a sorcery speed. It's not any time. Also, Veil of Summer. Usually, you can cycle it any time if you brought it in. Oh, you mean if you play main deck? Because they probably play this main deck. Pretty funny that they kept Overmaster post sideboard against me. I guess with Burning Wish, you don't really have that much cyber space. I'm just gonna concede. I mean, I know my opponent's gonna do fun things, but I'm just tired to be here and let my opponent have fun while I definitely do not have fun. But hopefully... Oh, wait, this is game one? I thought it was over. Never mind. Okay. Alright, let's bring in those cards. Let's take out these cards. These cards. These cards. Two more. Probably some smashy smashy. Yeah, I brought some smashy smashy. I got confused because of the Twister turn one. Could be. I can take out a rip. Ripperoni, pepperoni. No. Rest in peace. This card stops the combo. The Lion's Eye Diamond Echo of Yawns. I mean, no, it's fine. I don't like smashy smashy against combo. You might not believe it, but in 2006, no, what was it? 2007. I don't know. It was a paper PT, legacy PT. I don't know why I said paper. A legacy PT. And I played Eldrazi at the Legacy PT. Colorless Eldrazi. It was a great choice. And against combo, I used to take out Smasher for sure. All of them easily. Do I go Chalice on zero? Probably. Although, let's go Chalice on zero without even thinking about it. And then land go. So that if I draw Tondot's here, an Ancient Tomb, I can play Archon. You're surprised there was a Legacy PT? Yeah, there was. Okay, Vroom Vroom. Should I play Vroom Vroom over Rest in Peace? Yeah. The combo, Rest in Peace on Licensed Errors. But it's okay, if you have those, you don't need those, and vice versa. It was a Team Trios event, Legacy, Standard, Modern. Play with Javier and Kalk. Draw. Kataki. It kills all of my things. And then I'll attack for two. Nah, maybe it's... You know what? I will attack for two. Like, there's Chalice, so they can't go Lion's Eye Diamond plus the other thing. Do I have a background in poker too? No, I only play Magic my whole life. Opponent asked me a question I don't understand. Are you going to be Magic 30? Like 30 years old? 28 years old for your streamer Pepangu. Actually, what if I bring in swords? This killed Spurgy. This kills Spurgy. Oh, the 30th anniversary. Magic 30, the event. Oh, the Legacy event in Vegas. No, my friend, I'm sorry. I don't, but you'll find me at Four Seasons tournaments the 10th of September playing Legacy. I mean, Magic isn't 30. They just made it up. Magic was made like January 93.
It's barely 29. But this hand is good. I feel like I'm actually gonna win this match. I was born just after the unlimited set. I think I've checked it once. And that's the collection that I made. Are these two Kirtar Katars main or sideboard? You can go exclamation mark deck and check my list. They are indeed in the sideboard. Imagine losing the die roll. I mean. Okay. Three Galvanic Relays. What do you exile? Burgee, that's good. Lands of Diamond, that's also very good. And pass. Okay. Draw. Rest in the Pepperoni. Do I just go Thalia? Let's see. Let's go Thalia. Box Diamond. Discard cover. Discard Cavern, Ancient Tomb, Thalia, go. You wish you can celebrate your birthday all day long, all year long? That's too much. You don't want to do that. I mean, what's stopping you, right? Okay, so this is exiled, and this three cards, Burgee, Lanzai Diamond, and Rite of Flame, your opponent can cast. Rite of Flame will add them one mana, but actually need one mana to start with, because if they don't have a land, they can't cast much. Opponent and deep in the think. The calculations. Every time a storm opponent starts his turn, all I can think of is this meme. I should probably just download this meme and put it up every time. Every time my opponent thinks. Yeah, I'll do that. Max Heron, gifted a sub to Xigorat. Thank you so much, Mark Heron. The lesson here is that if you complain about advertisement on Twitch, you get a sub. So that's a pretty important lesson. Okay, my opponent has finished their calculations. And now... they're probably doing this too. What is it? They're probably doing this too, somebody says. Yeah, that's true. No, they're a much bigger brain. Okay, they empty their hand and have this? I'm in. Okay. All right. lol. Wrecked! Bing! Bada bing! It's Zagate! Alright, let's play Resting Pepe, I guess. Attack. Put Playing with one card in hand, one permanent on turn four. That's a goal. I'm glad. So the takeaway here is that any deck can be good against the combo. You just need to side in 55 cards and you'll win. All right, 2-2. We might actually win a treasure chest. Thank you for my inadvertently reminding to hydrate constantly. Yeah, right? Drink, 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 drink. Chest opening? No, I never open chest. Who do you think I am? Who do you think I am? A chest opener? Not me. I've never opened a single booster in my life. If you want to see how many boosters I have at home. I'm gonna play with a hand that's bad. Like, its hand is bad. Like, it's a hand that you open it and you're like, wait, who put these cards in my hand? But if I draw a land, if I can curve out, I'm just gonna keep. My channel reward. I really dislike channel reward on Twitch. Like, I watch Nassif stream all the time, and he has all these super annoying things that chat spams with the points. They just heard this. I don't know why he does it. Like, the channel rewards with Mamba Mia, they're really bad. I don't know. Okay, we drew a land. Put Nassif of Plains, though. Like, it's so bad. Like, who enjoys that? Do you actually watch and enjoy people spamming constantly noise? Like, it can't be true. And, you know, it's fine if it's Canister, because, you know, everyone knows Canister. But Nassif isn't known to be, like, a spammer, you know? It's very strange for me. I think the sub alert is okay if it's annoying. Like, at the end of the day, it's people, like, it's how you make money off the stream. It's people subbing you because there's no ads. The ads don't pay at all on Twitch. There are, but they don't pay at all. But the points, the China points, that just doesn't make any sense to me. All right, let's go Archon of Emeria. They don't spam them all the time. Oh, they do. At least whenever I see, they do. But this wasn't a start to complain about Nassif stream. It was mostly a start to say that I'm never gonna use my channel points. They don't trade. Interesting. Interesting. I wouldn't mind drawing a couple of lands in a row here, especially if they're colorless, so I can cast my cards. That would be nice. You know what I don't want to draw? Ancient Tomb. No, sorry, no Ancient Tomb. Mox Diamond. I want to draw Ancient Tomb if it's possible. What's my favorite card in Magic history? Black Lotus. Black Lotus. What are you supposed to spend your 51,000 Mango Bucks on? So, you can... Moderate Realms. This is annoying. You can write purple messages. Oh, no, vabbè. I called for Mox Diamond and I drew Mox Diamond. The classic. Name a more iconic thing. Thank you, Mark Heron. Yeah, see, you can write purple messages. Isn't that nice? Mm-hmm. Thank you, Mark Heron, for the tier one sub. Appreciate it. Purple massage. Okay, three. No, you plowed. For three mana, you plowed. Okay. And Wasteland. No. My Ganjo. What's the Suru 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 song? It's, I don't know, it's an old meme and I never bother changing it. Attenzione, Eldrazi Temple of the top. Attenzione, Eldrazi Temple of the top. That's an amazing draw. What you got? Crimson Zenith. No, another Wasteland. This is the Void. You can't protect this, Mom. You can't touch this, Mom. Mom, this Eldrazi Displacer toy is mine. They don't know it! No! No, they didn't know it! They didn't know it! And then they realized it. Porca boia. Wasteland. It's okay, I'll draw another one, don't worry. I'll draw another one. Eldrazi Temple. East Plains better than Mux Diamond, yeah. I'll attack with my Devoid guys. Da-dan! Take that, Mother of Runes. They just died to colorless beaters. Dos life. Imagine if I had mana to use my Displacer on. I could go draw step, blink Thanatseer. Pretty bad. Take that, Mom. Three cards in hand, they got a Bayou and two mystery card. Yeah, Giver of Runes is better. Yes, I win! I win! Crazy. Bene, bene, bene. Goodbye, Chalice. Anything else worth adding? Probably Cathar Commando can't be bad. Yeah, I think I like Cathar Commando. They surely have Stoneforge Mystic and like Badass cool things like that. Thalia also bad, but at least it's a 2-1 first strike that attacks. I really dislike Mox Diamond in this type of like slower matchups. And people say the Void was a bad mechanic, right? The Void, best mechanic in the world. Everyone remembers it. You want to take out hers? No, don't take out hers. Is hers better than Mox? In general? No, Mox is better. But here, I think against Maverick, I think it's alright. The Void was cool in draft too. My brain decides to forget certain things. And I entirely forgot the draft Oath of Gatewatch. I remember I played that PT. I went 3-3 in draft with, and 7-3 in modern with Eldrazi at the Oath of Gatewatch PT. But I don't remember anything of what I played. All right, Mulligan to 6, nice Mox Diamond. I hate Mox Diamond so much. All right, I think I have to Mulligan this hand. I mean, obviously if I draw land, it's a good hand, but let's be real. Let's be real. Okay, bottom. What do I bottom? Huh. Wasteland? Yeah. Forest Noble Hark. I'll go Ancient Tomb, go. Next turn, I hope I draw Plains so I don't have to go Kyra naming Archon, but I will. I mean, I guess I can also play Thanatseer. Nah, I probably will plow, so I don't want to play Thanatseer. Alright, take this uncountable Archon of Emeria. Take this uncountable Archon of Emeria, opponent. Kamigawa Forest. The last time I played Magic Arena, this were the default forest. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. When I think about this forest, I think about Naya runes in standard. I don't know why. 3 mana. Endurance. Attenzione. But it could have easily get me. Like 100%. I would have 100% attack. And they would have ambushed me. I could have played Thanatsir on turn 2. It's just that they plow mana up. It's not good, I think. So I'm going to bait the plow here and then play Thanatsir. Maybe smash her first. Take 4. This is a 4-5. It's like basically a leatherback Baeloth. 3 mana, 4-5. Ooh, tapped by you. Does that mean that they don't have an answer for my... Well, and the problem is that if they let me attack here, I can't attack with the Archon because of another Endurance. I mean, I know it sucks if they just have Plow, but what can I do? Just chump attack? I don't think it's good. And now the road for Thanatsir is opened. Because the thing is that if they plow your Thanatsir, it's not a good deal. Because they draw a card. So you're trading 2 cards for 2 cards. No, sorry. They draw a card. Okay, Wasteland tapped. Although now maybe they're empty their hands, so Thanatsir doesn't discard anything. I want to draw Palace Jailer. Vroom vroom. Okay. I'll go land TKS. I can only play one spell per turn, but if my opponent plows this... Okay, they don't. Nice. Yeah, I can't play a second spell. Do I want to double block the Endurance? Nah. Why not Wasteland or Wasteland? Oh, I don't mind. You know why? Because I mostly thought that my opponent would plow this in response and they would cast this afterwards. Wasteland or Black Swords? Nah, they have Marsh Flats in it. It's fine. Just let him wasteland. I have nothing but lands. Who cares about wasteland? Isn't that a Daniel Johnson shirt? It is. Whenever I stream with this shirt, people point it out. I change shirts once in a while. No, sorry. I meant to say every day. So I put this shirt on once in a while. Yeah. I don't change shirts once in a while. Trust me. It's very hot. Alright, go to 9. You wastelanded my temple. Okay. Draw. Ah, Cathar Commando. Bono. Put another wasteland tapped. Okay. Attack for 6 here. And then I play Cathar Commando. Sorry, Unlicensed Arson. I'll play Licensed Arson and pass because I can't cast this as well. You do change shirts once in a while? No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. Don't put words in my mouth that I didn't say, chat. One Endurance against the world. Hope it remains like that. I mean, I guess if you were a journalist, you could say that. Because journalists don't need the full context. They only need the words. I'm sure they could invent some system that, I don't know, puts the sound of the voice of, let's say, Elon Musk and makes him say random things. I guess then you would need to go to court. Prismatic ending on my hearse. No, my vroom vroom. Okay. I'll exile. Two spells at random. They have already that on text to speech. It already exists. Yeah. Cool invention. That's the progress that we need. Ha, opponent, what do you do now? Do you attack? You waste on my cavern. Alright. Do you attack or stay back? Attack. Okay. So I go to how much? Six. No, five. Do I want to play Cathar Commando? Probably not. Probably not. Attack, attack. If you take, you go to five. And then my Cathar Commando will be lethal. Assuming you don't draw anything. Should I wasteland you? If I wasteland you, you can't cast, well, five drop. Who cares about five drop? You go. If they break now, we win. Because they never expect a Cathar Commando. Like, nobody expects a 3-1 flesh. Grinson's in for 5. Grinson's... No. Questing Beast. Sure, I'll die. I'll die with honor to a Questing Beast. A beast with the quests. This might be the last play of the game. If opponent plays a Tapland... Ooh, what do you do? No, 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 what's that? It's not a Tapland. What's that? No, El Spirito del Labirinto. Okay. Let's go Cathar Commander. This is an enchantment. I could kill it. Should I kill it? No. I'll take my turn. Doesn't even have an art. This is the classic magical land experience. It doesn't have an art here. And then... It has an art here, and it has an art if you enlarge it, but it doesn't have an art. Alright, draw a good card. Va bene, va bene. That's a chump blocker. That's a chump blocker. So the plays I can make here are... Just attack with Archon. Yeah, I'll attack with Archon. Then I play a Thalium. And pass. Now I can block and sack. And they slowly die to my Archon here. That's what makes it a spirit. One card in hand for them. They just drew it. Top deck mode. Top deck mode game. Of bad creatures. Bad creatures playing against each other. Who will win first? The bad colorless and white creature or the bad green and white creatures? Opponent now doing the calculation. Okay, goes to combat. Why not attack with TKS? Yes. I just pass. All right, let's go. Oh! can cast it. I think I attack with TKS now. I didn't attack because I could have double blocked, plus maybe Questing Beast. Chat puts me the fear of Questing Beast in my mind. Let's attack TKS. What you do about it? Why not attack with Archon? I will let you answer by yourself. Okay. Your turn. Please don't Questing Beast me now. I should have obviously attacked with Talonsphere last turn as well. That was a punt. Okay, someone attacked. No, babe, you drew Scavenging Booze? There's only one creature in the graveyard though. It's not the end of the world. Okay, they fetch for a nice top land. They go to 2 life. Still not dead for 1 life, unfortunately. Cause they go to 3 here with the Scavenging Booze. Untap, draw. Umezawa's Jite. La Jite. Do I attack with TKS? No. Let me think. If I attack with TKS, what do they do? Double block. And then what do I do? Kill the booze. No, I don't think it's good. I just play Jite. Jite. Go. Opponent is in Hellbent mode, and the Scavenging Ooze can only be a 3-3. What a game. This is only game 2. Man, this league has been so long. How about, it's 2 hours and 20 minutes. Classic. Classic Legacy. Every match is so long in Legacy. Unless you're playing as combo, but nobody really play combo. Do we keep Thalion Swing? Definitely. I will definitely keep Thalion Swing. How often do you play Legacy in paper? Actually, tonight, I've been invited to a Carbonara and Legacy. And I accepted it. You drew Knight of the Reliquary. Oh, Caboya, that's big. Draw. A Ganjo. Hey, Ganjo, come with us. Alright, what if I go attack with Archon, the block with Endurance, and I a Ganjo? Eh? The Endurance. I think it's a good play. Or, let me think, what other play I have? I can equip the Archon. Attack with the Archon. Oh, no, aspetta, keep the Thalia. Attack with Thalia and Archon. The Endurance blocks Archon. The Thalia gets chump blocked by the Knight. And then, it makes more sense that I just take Ganjo. Yeah. The Knight will get a... Do they have Maze of Ith? They don't, right? Skill pattern. I don't really think you know what's going on, so just try to watch for now. I mean, I love everyone trying to interact, but there is a lot of names on this magic. There's a lot of words on this magic cards, so if you don't exactly know them all, don't. Alright, let's try and check with Archon, the block with Ender, and say Ganjo, pass the turn. Maybe the... I I don't mind chatting with chat. It's fun, but backseating when you don't really know what's going on, it's a little bit annoying as a streamer. Not that I care, of course, but all right, opponent obviously has to block. Top of the wasteland or top of the plains? Top of the wasteland. And pass. You gain a counter on the ooze. And pass. You get a four. Pass. The Knight of the Reliquary can also start attacking next turn. It's not unreasonable. If they brick, like if they draw a good old land here, we just equip the Archon, we attack, we're safe. Right. Draw step. Hopefully it's bad. Hopefully it's bad. Okay, so the question is, what cards do they have with knight? Ooh, they move to combat. I think that's an attack of knight. No attacks? Allora, vamos. Plains. Jit, equip until here. And attack with Archon. If they have Maze of Ith, they will untap my Archon. If they don't have Maze of Ith, they'll take 2 damage. Okay. Now, do I want to move the Jit? Or do I want to keep up Wasteland? I think moving the Jit is reasonable. Yeah, I can also gain life and then tap the tomb if I want to. We'll move it on to here. Yeah. On TKS. And go. I think I'll play this tomb now. I draw Mox Diamond. Oh, I already played a land. I did. All right. Then I'll pass. Let's see what I get. Hopefully they just get a fetch. I can't even get a fetch land. Dried Arbor, that's true. Dried Arbor, they can get that one. Tapped end of turn. I don't want to kill any creature because of the scavenging ooze. I'll let you have all the creatures. I don't care. Right, Maze of Ith was coming to play tapped, so definitely that wasn't a scared card to be scared of. White green, what'd you draw? Is that an ending? Hope not. That would be annoying. Please, opponent, just die. Yes. Yes. 3-2, la 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 la.